Good morning. It's good to be here. I haven't gone anywhere. I just haven't been here on Sunday. But it's good to be with you this morning, and it's a wonderful day, and it's full of life. And let us listen to God's word. Let us be motivated in what we say and do as a result of what we have taken to ourselves and what God has given equally as a gift. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
May grace and peace of God, Creator, may the love of Jesus, who gives life and resurrection, may the Holy Spirit in its gifts be given to you in abundance. Good. You're getting used to my English. Okay. Let us pause as we begin, aware of the times when we have not chosen correctly. For you were sent into this world to heal those who are sincere and contrite. O Lord, have mercy. And you came to call sinners to life and forgiveness. Christ, have mercy. And you would intercede for us to the God of all. Lord, have mercy. May then the Almighty forgive, understand, and bring all of us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, through the grace of adoption, you chose us. We are your children of light, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. This we pray in Jesus. You live and reign with the Spirit. You are one forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. And may I have the children come forward. Come on, there's more of you. Can you hold this? And can you lead them and learn with them? Go straight down the middle, okay? Help her out, boys, so she doesn't trip. Girl, you can go. You don't have to pose. They'll all follow you. Precious. Follow the rest of them, boys.
A proclamation from the Book of Wisdom. God did not make death, and he does not delight in the death of the living. For he created all things so that they might exist. The generative forces of the world are wholesome, and there is no destructive poison in them. And the dominion of Hades is not on earth. For righteousness is immortal, for God created man for incorruption and made him in the image of his own eternity. But through the devil, death entered the world, and those who belong to his company will experience it. The word of the Lord.
Proclamation from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, now, as you excel in everything, in faith, in speech, in knowledge, in utmost eagerness, and in our love for you, we also want you to excel in this generous undertaking. For you know the generous act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich. I do not mean that there should be relief for others and pressure on you, but it is a question of a fair balance between your present abundance and their need, so that their abundance may be for your need, in order that there may be a fair balance. As it is written, the one who had much did not have too much, and the one who had little did not have too little. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Holy Gospel according to Mark. And when Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a large crowd gathered. He stayed close to the sea. One of the synagogue officials, named Jairus, came forward, and seeing him, he fell at his feet, pleading earnestly and saying, "My daughter is at the point of death. Oh, please come, lay your hands on her, that she would be well and live." He went off with him, and the crowd followed and pressed upon him. There was a woman who was afflicted with hemorrhages now for 12 years, and she suffered greatly at the hands of many doctors and had spent everything that she had. Yet she was not even helped, and she only grew worse. She heard about Jesus, and she came up behind him in this crowd and touched his cloak. She said, "If I but touch the clothes, I shall be cured." And immediately her flow of blood dried, and she felt in her body that she was healed. Jesus, aware that power had gone out, turned around and asked, "Who's touched my clothes?" The disciples said, "You see, the crowd is pressing upon you, yet you asked who touched me?"
He looked around to see who had done it. And the woman, realizing what happened, approached in fear and trembling. She fell before Jesus and told him the truth. He said, "Daughter, your faith has saved you. Go in peace and be cured of this affliction." And while still speaking, people from the synagogue official's house arrived to say, "Your daughter has died. Why trouble the teacher any longer?" Disregarding the message that was reported, Jesus said to the synagogue official, "Do not be afraid. Just have faith." He did not allow anyone to go with him inside the house, except for Peter and for James and for John. When they arrived, he caught sight of a commotion and people weeping and wailing loudly, and so they went in. "Why the commotion and weeping?" he said. "The child is not dead, but asleep." They ridiculed him, and he had them all put out. And he took the child's father and mother and the three mentioned to enter the room where the child was. He took the child by the hand and said, "Talitha koum, little girl, I say to you, arise." The girl, a child of 12, arose immediately and walked around, and at that they were truly astounded. He gave strict orders that no one should know this and said that they should give her something to eat. The good news of the Lord.
Still thinking of that little girl with the book. She's a long way from 12 yet. You and I are familiar with wisdom. We hear it so often at masses of resurrection. The souls of the just are in the hands of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seem in the view of the foolish to be dead. They're going forth utter destruction. No, they are at peace. Here we have another reading from wisdom, proclaimed to us by someone young. God made you and each of us to last, to be imperishable. I hope you heard that. That's what was said. God did not make death. God made life. And certainly Jesus said that I have come to give them life, to have it more abundantly, to understand that. Goes on further in wisdom to say, everything that God made is good. Everything has a noble purpose. Oh, even all the herbs and medications and everything else out there. They have a good side. They have an upside. That's what they're to be used for. What has made them wrong? People. People that choose to use things for the wrong purpose. People that choose death rather than life. It says in that last verse, does it not, that the devil and his followers choose death, choose nothingness, choose the absence of good, choose the absence of God. God gave us free will. Gave us those choices. All we actually have to do is affirm life in so many ways, affirm goodness, affirm God's creation. What do we do with it? We mess it up, don't we? Collectively, social sin. They can't figure out what to do with all the plastic anymore. The plastic straws, the plastic containers, choking our oceans. You take something good and misuse it. Another main point in today's readings, especially the second reading, Paul to the Corinthians, is a lesson about equality. And Paul was a man familiar with the Old Testament. What was he doing in talking here in Corinth? Well, he was fundraising. He was asking the people of Corinth to be generous with what they had to send on to Jerusalem, whether they were suffering. He cites also in another spot how the Macedonians up in Greece were so generous and that they were so poor, and yet they were so kind and generous and gave so much. There is a reference there in the last line that those who have more will have enough, and those who don't have or are collected enough will have the same amount. That's a reference to Exodus. It's a reference to the desert experience when they were out there and they were asked to gather the manna. And somehow, even God had his hand in that situation. Because those who couldn't gather the whole basket somehow had a whole basket. And those who had gathered a lot still only had what they were proportioned to have. Equality. Something that our faith calls us to. That we are made in the image and likeness of God to be imperishable, to be forever, to be part of eternity, to affirm ourselves with that hope, to work and live and share what God has given us with our brothers and sisters. Then we have this marvelous story of the Gospel of Mark. One of three occasions, one of which was a widow who was at a funeral of her only son, who was her whole support because she was a widow, and they were carrying him out. And Jesus touched the litter and the pallbearers and stopped them and returned him to his mother. Then we have this occasion, this little girl, 12. Oh, and they're tearing their clothes and they're crying and there's much ado. And who does he take in? Mom, Dad, Peter, to see this. James, our patron, and John. Does he do anything dramatic? No, he takes her by the hand. Little girl, arise. You're always giving me good information around here. One of you brought, where is she? Where are you? Huh? Way in the back? There she is back there, okay. She's showing me pictures of how she's been in this chair forever and now she's standing and doing rehab and doing all kinds of wonderful things. And I said, listen to the gospel today. Speaking to you, even though you're still a little girl. 60 plus, I'll give you. Well, little girl, arise. And God is saying that to you and me this morning. Friend, arise. Live in the light. You have been made good. Your brothers and sisters have been made good. Share together. Make sure everyone has enough. Remember the bumper sticker? God didn't make junk. God made you, and he's calling you. Arise, brother. Arise, sister, live in the light. You are good. You are to be part of forever. Don't give in to hopelessness. Don't twist what God has made into something it isn't. It's humankind that chose death. It's not really death, it's a door to eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
I didn't put my glasses on, but it's page 9, I think. Say it with me.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, descended.
Fairness, inequality, let us open our ears, let us hear the needs of others.
Our response will be, hear us, O Lord. Like Christ, may this church reach out, welcome, and accept all those who are in need of healing and community, so that they may be in closer relationship with God. O God, we pray.
Amen.
Today in Scripture, we hear that God created all things that they might have life. We pray that all nations might become havens of life, love, safety, and hope, encouraging all peoples to excel in every respect. For the nations, O God, we pray. St. Paul reminds us today, whoever had much did not have more, and whoever had little did not have less. May those of us who have much be aware that God calls us to share his gifts with those who have little. For the poor, O God, we pray. We enter now into our summer days, a time of light, harvest, and plenty. Let us not forget that many in our midst are suffering, are ill, or are in darkness. May they feel the warmth of your light and love even in their time of hardship. For the sick and suffering, O God, we pray. We give thanks for the safe return of our work campers at St. James. May God continue to inspire them. For all who do mission work, O God, we pray. We bring to you, Lord, all those intentions listed in our prayer intentions book. O God, we pray. We remember all the deceased members of St. James, those signed in our book of life. Richard Wagner, who recently died, and especially Camilo D'Amico, for whom this Eucharist is offered. O God, we pray.
One more thing we pray for, Lord. As you passed back and forth across the lake, help all who would travel on this holiday coming, visiting family and friends, to do so in safety and find welcome and bring words of comfort and peace. Grant an answer to all of these, we ask in Jesus.
Amen. Our presentation song is found on page 35, Lord, When You Came, page 35.
Thank you.
Oh, pray with me. Would you bring an offer that this would be acceptable by God? Receive, O Lord, what we offer in conciliation and praise, cleansed by this action, that this offering of heart be pleasing to you. Grant this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Together we give thanks to the Lord who is God. Truly it is right and just, our salvation, our responsibility, to always give you thanks. For you are the Almighty, you the Eternal. We do this in the light that is Jesus. Out of compassion for the waywardness that we are and do, Jesus humbled himself. By passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death to be life-giving. Now with the angels and the hosts of heaven, we sing. You, the source, the spring of all that is holy. Over our gifts, we pray. May you send the Holy Spirit that these now become body and blood of the risen Jesus. How he said yes and entered the passion. How he took bread and gave thanks to share and break. Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. How he took the cup to be shared, to offer it to them and say, take this now, all of you. Drink from it. This is chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and the everlasting covenant, for it has been poured for you and many, that sin is forgiven. Do this in memory of me. We celebrate the memorial of resurrection and eternal life. We offer the bread of life. We offer the chalice of salvation. We give thanks together that we are worthy to be here, that we might serve you humbly partaking of the body and blood of Christ, gather us in the Holy Spirit. Remember the church throughout the globe. We pray that you give her fullness of charity. We pray that you assist Francis, our Pope, our bishops, all who serve our people. We ask you to remember in this service Camillo, for he believed in you as resurrection and life. Bring him into that light. Mercy, we pray for, that we would join with him one day, join with Mary, join with Peter, James, John, who were with Jesus, join with all of the others, pleasing you through all ages to merit to be heirs to the eternal life and to praise and glorify you in the Lord. O, through Christ and with Christ, O, in Christ, in unity with the Spirit, that glory and honor belongs to you, O God, forever and ever. Amen. In those words, our Father, O Jesus, you said, peace I leave and give to you. Look not on fault, but faith. Give now, here, peace and unity forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace be with you this day. The word of today, arise, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are you who are called to the altar of the Lord. O body, blood of Jesus, bring us all to your life that is imperishable. Amen. enough for everyone, and even more here. I call forward those who would take communion to someone, make sure that they get their share of grace and God. Oh, I am impressed. But I know there's more out there who need to be fed. Let us find them. May God guide you in your travel and with your words and prayers. Amen.
Following are the announcements. Mass on the Grass is our way of celebrating the feast day of St. James, and we will celebrate on July 22nd. We hope you will plan to join us for Mass outside in the front of the chapel, and we ask that you please RSVP if you plan to join us for the family picnic afterwards. Check out the form in the bulletin or website, and RSVP by returning your slip, email us, or call the parish office. On Wednesday, July 4th, the parish offices will be closed and we will not have morning mass. We will also not have the adoration in the chapel on Tuesday, July 3rd, but you know you are always welcome to come and pray in the chapel. As always, for more information, check out the bulletin, website, and Facebook.
For those of you who don't know me, my name is Paul Schneider, and I sit on St. James Human Concerns Committee. And our committee, through your help, support, and volunteerism, support the community through other organizations. Today we're going to hear from Heather Stofkoff, who works with a former organization called Interfaith Senior Program. Their new name is now Eros, and they help the disabled, the senior community, and those with special needs in the Waukesha area. So please welcome Heather Stofkoff.
Good morning. Thank you for having me back to speak. I was here, I think, in 2016, so it's nice to be back. As Paul said, my name is Heather Stofkoff, and I'm proud to be the development manager at ERA's Senior Network, formerly known as Interfaith Senior Programs. St. James has supported our agency through financial gifts to our Faith in Action program, by volunteering your time, and through support of our holiday giving program. So thank you very much. If you are unfamiliar with ERAS, we are a community-based nonprofit serving seniors and adults with disabilities all throughout Waukesha County. Our mission is to engage and support Waukesha County seniors and adults with disabilities in leading meaningful lives. We support people through volunteer services that help seniors and adults with disabilities maintain their independence. So those services include transportation to medical appointments or the grocery store, seasonal yard cleanup, which is a really great opportunity for youngsters out there, friendly visiting, and more. And currently we are serving 13 people from St. James. And then also in the mission is engaging seniors. And staying engaged is so important in reducing isolation and the feelings of loneliness. More and more studies are coming out relating loneliness to all kinds of negative side effects, including increased depression, increased likelihood of falling ill, and shortened lifespan. They say that loneliness is as dangerous as smoking 15 cigarettes a day. So to help seniors stay engaged, we offer meaningful volunteer opportunities through the Retired and Senior Volunteer Program, otherwise known as RSVP. These opportunities include tutoring in over 20 area schools, many of which are here in Menomonee Falls, helping out with our pen pal programs, volunteering in the ERA's office, at the other nonprofits that we partner with, or by providing services for other seniors and adults with disabilities. And currently we have 16 volunteers who are from St. James Parish, so thank you so much for that. So right now, Waukesha County has the second largest senior population in the state. And basically, the folks that we're serving are in this gap. There's about 15% of our seniors qualify for government entitlement programs. And then there's another part of the population who are able to pay for their own services. But in between those groups is a gap of people who have once been financially stable but are no longer able to pay for things on their own if something unexpected comes up. So when people all of a sudden have new prescriptions or they're unable to drive and they need to pay for a cab service, they might have to think about those basic needs and determine which one they have to go without. We've had some people call in and say that they've had to cut their pills in half to be able to stretch out their medication, which is obviously not a safe choice. So thankfully, our clients hear about ERA's senior network through word of mouth, their congregation, the food pantry, and other community resources, and get a great sense of relief in knowing that while we encourage donations, all of our services are provided at no cost to our clients. So besides the programs that I mentioned, we offer many more programs and services to our community. We've developed the Stop Senior Frauds and Scams program in 2016, which is a presentation about popular frauds and scams targeting the senior population. And these presentations have been given all over the county and a little bit outside of the county to over 1,250 seniors and their caregivers so far. So if you're interested in our program, you can talk to me afterwards about that. Then we also have our holiday giving program, which you all have participated in for many years, and that provides self-sufficiency care packages to up to 500 seniors and adults with disabilities who are on a fixed income and also lack family support. And then we have a Find a Ride network that's going to be starting here in Menomonee Falls in September, which is going to be a one-call, one-click system as a better way of helping seniors get to where they need to go. So you can call one number or go on one website, and it'll be helping you find the best transportation provider for you. So look for more information coming soon. So to close, I just want to thank you again for your support of our programming and ask you to consider continuing that support. Your support can come in the form of a financial gift and a donation of items to our holiday giving program or by volunteering your time. Current volunteer needs, really, we need a lot more drivers. We're having an increase in driving requests, and it's always good to have help there. But there's other ways you can serve, including volunteering in the schools through our RSVP program, in our office, or through one of our seasonal yard cleanup days. And do we have any current volunteers here with ERAS? If so, raise your hand. Anyone? Oh, yeah, okay. Well, you know who to talk to then afterwards if you want to firsthand comment about it. Well, I'm going to be in the back after service and would love to talk to you and share my brochures with you. And I love to end all my presentations with my favorite anonymous quote that says, "To the world, you may be one person, but to one person, you may be the world." And thanks to the support that we receive from St. James and other community members, our organization is able to make that kind of impact on our clients. So thank you so much, and I hope to talk to you after service.
For the eyes of all look to you, O Lord, for it is you who give them food in due season. For we are renewed and nourished in the sacred body, the precious blood. We ask of your mercy, Lord, that we who celebrate with devotion may have that pledge of redemption. Grant us this in Christ.
Amen.
The Lord. Come on, get up. The Lord is with you. Be blessed and bring blessing to someone, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go from here in peace.
And as we go forth, let us all turn to page 18 and sing together a song of good news.